Hello, I'm Anna and I graduated from college last May, so about 2 months ago at this point. Enough time to reflect a little bit, enough time to think about my college experience, and now I'm sitting in a Target parking lot with my camera propped up on my dash, much more in public than I would like to be talking to a camera, to tell you just about what I wish I knew before college. So whether you are entering or whether you are in it right now, you can just have my little foods for thought to maybe think about as well. Whether it's helpful as advice or just as community for what you're feeling, whatever it is. Maybe alternate title, what I would tell myself starting college. But I think it's important to start with the very first, like very basic one that I think you'd hear. And oh, a guy's walking up. I feel so uncomfortable. Very basic one that you would hear. Oh, he's looking at me too. Very basic one that you would hear in just about every college tips video. And that is to get rid of, or at least try to, because that can be hard, to get rid of your unrealistic expectations for your college experience. And what I mean by this is don't expect it to be bad. Don't expect it to not be fun. Don't expect it to not be the best 4 years of your life. It might not be, but don't expect it to not be. But if your expectations for college are somebody else's and not yourself, for instance, if you see someone else's college experience and you're thinking that is what, okay, honestly, I cannot do this. I'm gonna have to drive to my house and then finish this. I'm gonna talk later in this video about confidence, and I think this is gonna be me showing that I do not have it yet. Mr. Pickup Trash Man is still looking at me. He is right next to me, picking up trash, like within 2 feet of me right now as I'm continuing to talk. See, I'm still a work in progress. This confidence is not here. Okay, see you when I get home. Okay, let's finish this video from the comfort of my own home. If you see someone else's college experience, whether that's someone you know personally, whether that's someone you subscribe to on YouTube, someone you follow on TikTok, or if it's just like the general American idea of the college experience, if those are your expectations, just know that what you see of that is not the full story. And I know that's not like groundbreaking. You've probably heard someone say that before. But if you expect your 4 years to be perfect, you make the best friends in your whole life, every day is something new, every day is something fun, you're gonna grow, you're gonna change, you're gonna have the time of your life, it's gonna be the best 4 years of your life, if those are your expectations, then you will be let down. And I don't want that to come across as like pessimistic advice or like college is gonna stink advice, because it really doesn't have to, it really doesn't have to. But if your expectation is for it to be completely perfect, for it to be the picture perfect college experience, then you're gonna get let down because your bar is set so high and so unrealistically. And so maybe having your highlights of college look like the highlights of the other people you see, maybe that can be a realistic goal. But just always remember that you never see someone's full story, but you know your own full story so deeply. Honestly, if possible, I think remove your expectations, because if you don't have expectations, then you can make the best out of whatever experience you're in, whatever situation you're in, the people you're around, everything, and feel like it is great, feel like it is going great. Whereas if your expectations are so high, and then in the first 3 days you haven't made your best friends, bridesmaids, aunties to your children friends, then you're gonna feel upset. And that's not the mindset that I want you to have throughout college, because it's just not a fun one to be in. Another thing that I didn't really know going into college is that this is one of the only times in your life where your time is truly yours. Whatever you want your day to look like, whatever you want to fill it with, whatever you want to involve yourself in, etc., is totally up to you, which is really special, because once you get a real full-time job, or once you get married, or once you have children, or just like the whole future of your life, whatever that you want it to look like, isn't going to be the same. But you can wake up in the morning and think like, okay, I have class from this time to this time, but the rest of the hours is totally up to you and how you feel it, whether it's by something you get involved in, like a sorority or a club or a sport, or if you do choose to get a part-time job, whatever it is, it's totally up to you what you fill those hours with, which is just so unique. And so I hope that you can make the most of it as soon as you start college, because honestly, I don't think I really realized that until my last year, just thinking of how special my time was and the fact that it was just my time. But if you know that going in, then you can really just make the best of those 3 to 5 years, however long college takes you, and prioritize the things that you do want to fill your hours with. The next piece of advice that I wish I knew going into college is that a lot of the college advice I received isn't necessarily for everyone, and you don't always have to do it. For example, one of the things I just thought of is like, before I went into college, I always heard like, communicate with your professors, email them, get to know them, say hi to them so they know your name. And I just want to say like, I did not do that in most of my classes through college, because that just wasn't who
I was. Like, sometimes maybe I sat close to the front, but honestly, I kind of preferred to just be invisible in my larger lecture classes. And most of the professors probably didn't know my name. Now, that's not true for every class, because, like, for instance, in the School of Social Work, where my major was, those professors I really did know and talk to outside of class, just because it was natural, and, you know, I had questions to ask them, they reached out to me. But, like, in the classes that really don't matter to you, learn something, learn what the class is teaching you. If you really like the professor, reach out to them, but don't feel pressure to be the star. I don't know if this is bad advice. Just don't feel pressure to be, like, the star pupil, to know all of your professors, to have all of them know your name, to have, like, 25 possible reference letters for you later. Like, you don't need that. Just, if there are professors that you click with, perfect. Hone in on those relationships. But I remember I always felt bad, because I was like, these professors don't know me. I do the bare minimum. I show up to class. Like, I'm getting good grades because, like, I was doing the class, but I wasn't doing the whole, like, extra college thing. And I felt bad about that, when, like, really, I don't think it would have benefited me that much. So that is to say, like, whatever college advice you hear, just make it fit you. And if it doesn't fit you, don't do it. I guess that's the advice I wish I would have known. That was my ice. Something else I wish I knew before entering college is that I feel like everyone else suddenly became super professional and I got left behind. Like, people were joining, like, their professional clubs. People were getting, like, actual jobs and internships. People were needing to wear business casual randomly for, like, job fairs, or people were having mock interviews. And I never got the memo to start doing that until it seemed like all of my peers were doing that and preparing for their jobs and schooling after college, and I had no idea. So I don't know if I have a piece of advice here, if it was just something I wish I'd known, but just start looking for the, like, job and internships and schooling after, whatever you're gonna do, whenever you feel ready. Like, if everyone your freshman year is joining professional programs and doing, like, things that really seem good for their future, if that's what you want to do, do it. But also remember to, like, be in college while you're in college. I think it's so tempting to, in your first semester, start thinking, oh, what am I gonna do after I graduate? And it is important to have a plan. Like, I'm not telling you don't plan, but just remember, like, you're there for 4 years, and that's a long time. So make the most of being in college without needing to plan it all away, wish it all away. And that goes with, like I said, like, the professional preparing for your job, but also with just planning for what you want your life to look like after college. Try to delay that, because you will be able to plan it. You will know what you want your life to look like after college. But when you're in the middle of it, try to remember how much you were waiting for this moment throughout your whole life. I think it's so easy to start just wishing away whatever stage of life you're in. And so with college, try not to do that. Try not to move too fast. Just enjoy the spot that you're in while you're in it, because little you always wanted to be there. You know what I mean? Another thing I wish I would have known entering college, you do not have to be over-involved at your wit's end for your entire 4 years there. I think I felt the need to juggle so many balls, have so many little eggs to put in different baskets throughout my whole college career, because it seemed like everyone else was doing that, and I felt like I was getting behind by not having, like, 7 different clubs I was joining and always needing to do something and be somewhere. But honestly, for me, anytime I tried that, anytime I tried to over-involve myself, it just meant that I was not fulfilling the responsibilities that I was signing up for, because I could not juggle that many balls. And so I think it's important to just do what your capacity is and what you want your capacity to be, and not feel the pressure to do more. For instance, if you want to join a sorority, do that, be happy with that. If you have extra time you want to fill, then maybe add something else in, but don't start with 10 different things and then let the responsibilities not get fulfilled. Instead, I would say to start slow, find what you truly want to be involved in. Don't feel ashamed to cut off your involvement with something if it just isn't working for you anymore. And don't feel the pressure to be the, like, typical stay up till 3 a.m. studying every night because you were just so busy and you have an exam tomorrow, but you didn't have study until then and you don't get any sleep and you're always stressed and your calendar's always full. You don't have to do that. If that's what you want to do, sure, go for it. But that is not what I wanted to do. And I felt guilt about that for probably the first, actually every year of college. I felt guilt about that because that just wasn't who I wanted to be and that wasn't how I wanted my life to be. But I felt like I wasn't good enough because I wasn't so involved with everything. Don't take this piece of advice to say don't get involved, because it is really nice to have things that you want to do, whether that's volunteering, an organization, a job, whatever it is, but don't overexert yourself because that's no fun and you want to appreciate the moments that you're in, and you really can't do that if you don't even have time to stop and think. Something else that I wish I knew is that your life is literally all about balance while you're in college in, like, every realm of it. But for instance, you need to balance the schooly things and the fun things because you are at college for school. That's why you're there. You want to get a degree, you want to learn, you want to be good at whatever career you want to do in the future. But you can't only be doing studying, exam, classes. You also need to balance having fun and with finding friends, finding fun things to do, finding events to go to. But you can't only be doing the fun things and letting the school go. That's all about balance. I think you need to find balance in planning planning out your life and then also just being spontaneous and seeing where life takes you. I tend to kind of trend more towards the planning side of things, but it is important to just kind of let you roll with life as well. So I think that's a balance you have to find in college. You have to find a balance between your relax time, your recharge time, making sure you're taking care of yourself while also being a little bit go, go, go if you want to be involved in things. If you do want to have time commitments, then it requires you obviously being productive, doing things, but you can't be total grind culture, never taking care of yourself, but you also can't be just laying in bed all day, never doing anything productive for you or for your future or for your school. It really just is all about balance, and everybody's balance is going to look very different. Like with the ones that I mentioned, I think I had a pretty good middle between like school things and fun things, but I tend to go very much more on the planned side and I go very much more on the relax side, I think usually, just because I really value my recharge time. But it's just important to find where you fit in those little balances and not trying to make yourself fit where you feel like you should, but really genuinely what your personality needs to be successful and to feel happy through these 3 to 5 years of your life of college. Now, the most important thing that I would tell myself, my 2018 little freshman self, 18 years old, just graduating high school, ready to start anew at college, is that this truly is the time to, it's gonna be so cheesy, to find yourself, to become who you want to be. And I say that because even if you're going to school with a bunch of your high school friends in your hometown, there's still gonna be new people. It's still a new environment. Or if you're truly just like uprooting and going to a new state where you don't know anybody, that was me. It is all about new beginnings. And it's very different than high school where people have known you for a long time and you kind of have, you know their expectations of you, you kind of know what they think of you. And so you kind of fulfill that whether or not you want to. In college, I think it's really important to just let that go and truly do what kind of lifestyle you want to do, whatever that may be. And so with that comes with trying to gain the confidence of making your own choices and feeling confident in the choices that you make and not trying to think of what other people are going to think of you, what their opinions are going to be of your choices, just because that becomes so much less important as you grow older, as your life becomes less structured, like just out of high school, essentially, that becomes so much more important. And confidence is something that is very, very hard to come by, hard to create, and I think everyone struggles with it for most of their whole life. I'm a big proponent of just fake it till you make it. If you are, I don't know, this is gonna be a petty example, but like if you're wanting to try a new outfit or a new outfit style and you're thinking people are gonna look at me weird, people are gonna think it doesn't look good, except like just put on the outfit, pretend you're really confident, walk out of your house playing a character that's really confident in that outfit, and soon you'll realize that that just becomes habit, that just becomes easy to do. You'll stop thinking about whether or not people are looking at you, whether or not people are thinking about you. I really think that in college, that's when that starts to become so much less important. Not that it's important earlier in life, but you feel that it's so much less important what other people are thinking of you, because circling back to the first point or the second point, whatever it was, how your time is truly yours, and that's unique in college, it's the first time that you really just get to make your own choices. And that's a big gift, like having the independence to make your own choices from as big and from as small as just like which groceries you buy each week to as big as your major and your future and where you want your life to go. That's a huge blessing to get to choose. And so I hope that entering college, you can go in with the mindset of just thinking of how special it is that you get to be whoever you are and you don't have to conform to society's standards if you don't want to. And I think the earlier you begin thinking about that and the earlier you know that, the better it is for you, honestly. Just like the better the outcome, the quicker you'll come to be who you really want to be. And college is really a special time for that. I hope some of this was helpful. I'm not the wisest person in the world, but I did go through it and have reflected some and definitely changed a whole lot in the years that I was at the University of Alabama. And I don't think anyone really exits college being the exact same person that they went into it. Actually, no one leaves college being the exact same person that they went into it being. So if you're starting in the fall, that's awesome. I wish you the best. I love the person that you are now, but I'm excited to see the person that you will become as you go through college, as you gain the independence, as you become into your true self. And I hope some of these little pieces of advice at least cause you to think whether or not you implement them. I hope they at least cause you to reflect a little bit on what you're expecting. And I genuinely do hope that your college years are the best so far of your life. I'll see you next time.